In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Right Triangle Congruence. Before we start number one, let's go over the four different ways we know that right triangles are congruent. So here we have two right triangles. The first theorem we're going to go over is HL, or hypotenuse-leg theorem. That states that if the hypotenuse and one leg of a right triangle is congruent to the hypotenuse and the other leg of a right triangle, then those triangles are congruent. The next way we can tell that right triangles are congruent is by the HA, or hypotenuse angle. This one states that if the hypotenuse of one right triangle and an acute angle of the right triangle is congruent to the hypotenuse and an acute angle of the other triangle, then those right triangles are congruent. So we have hypotenuse leg, hypotenuse angle. We also have LL, or leg, which states that if one leg is congruent to a leg of another right triangle and the other leg is also congruent to the other leg of the right triangle, then the right triangles are congruent. And lastly, we have LA, leg angle. That says if one leg is congruent to another leg and an acute angle of one right triangle is congruent to an acute angle of the other right triangle, then those triangles are congruent. So knowing those four different theorems, let's get started with number one. Remember, HL, hypotenuse leg, HA, hypotenuse angle, LL, leg, LA, leg angle. So number one, our directions are to state if the two triangles are congruent. If they are, state how you know. And number one, the triangles share the same side so that we know that this side is congruent to itself. Since both of these are right triangles, this leg is congruent to this leg, and this leg is congruent to itself. So these right triangles are congruent because of LL, leg theorem. And number two, one leg is congruent to the other leg, and the hypotenuses are congruent. So we have an H and an L congruent to an H and an L. Therefore, we know that these two triangles are congruent because of the HL hypotenuse leg theorem. And number three, we have that the two hypotenuses are congruent, and we have that two acute angles are also congruent. Therefore, in number three, the right triangles are congruent because of HA, hypotenuse angle. In number four, we have two right triangles in which one hypotenuse is congruent to the other hypotenuse and one acute angle is congruent to the other acute angle. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent because of hypotenuse angle, HA. In number five, these two triangles share a similar side, and we know that this side is congruent to itself, and that is also the hypotenuse. So the hypotenuse is congruent to itself, and we have one acute angle congruent to another acute angle. Therefore, since they're both right triangles, we know that these two triangles are congruent because of HA, hypotenuse angle. In number six, we're given that one acute angle is congruent to another acute angle, and both of them are right triangles. However, we're not given any other information. Therefore, in number six, these two triangles are not congruent. In number seven, I have these two sides are congruent, and these two sides are congruent, and this angle is congruent to this angle. However, there's no indicated 90-degree angle in either of these triangles, and even if we were to try to use SAS, side, angle, side, this angle is not the included angle. Therefore, in number seven, these two triangles are not congruent. And number eight, my triangles share the same side, and that side happens to be a leg. So this leg is congruent to itself, and this leg is congruent to this leg. Therefore, number eight, the right triangles are congruent because of the LL leg theorem. And number nine, we're given two right triangles in which an acute angle from each is congruent. And we also know that these two angles are vertical angles and are also congruent. However, we do not have a theorem that proves that these two triangles are congruent because remember, we're dealing with HL, hypotenuse leg, HA, hypotenuse angle, LL, leg, or LA, leg angle, and we have none of those in number 9. Therefore, these two triangles in number 9 are not congruent. And lastly, in this video, we'll go over number 10. Number 10, we can see that we have two right triangles, since that 90 degrees is a vertical angle, and we also have that one leg is congruent to the other leg of another triangle, and this leg is congruent to the other leg of the other triangle as well. Therefore, the two right triangles in number 10 are congruent by LL, leg. And I'll stop the video here. Join me in the next video where I'll finish out this worksheet completing the second page. If you haven't already, click that subscribe button so that you're updated when I come out with new videos and give this one a thumbs up.